Over the past few months, I've gotten really interested in learning about 3D art, specifically with how it's implemented in video games. 2D games have and will still continue to be relevant, of course, but 3D just inherently creates so many opportunities to do cool and interesting things, whether it's something complex like a large open world to explore, or something relatively simple like dynamic camera angles. There's genuinely been so much research and development put into this mind-blowing technology that you don't even think about when playing because we're already used to seeing in three dimensions in real life. Every little detail you can perceive has taken an insurmountable level of effort just to be visible on your screen. So that's why when Star Aced approached me, asking me to break down how they're using advanced systems in tech to bring their characters to life for a sponsored video, I thought it would be a great opportunity to explain some of these concepts and how they've been able to elevate the modern video gaming experience to such a high degree. As the name implies, Love in Deep Space is unabashedly a romance game, so naturally it would be very difficult to become invested in these characters if they didn't feel alive, especially since a lot of the time you're playing from a first-person perspective, seeing every detail up close. Each of the five male leads has different personality traits for you to discover through playing the game, and a lot of that has to come through from their physical acting. So that's why it makes a lot of sense for motion capture to be used to really sell the nuance in their movements, on top of it being easier to create animations faster than by hand. In terms of modern motion capture technology, it generally looks something like this. It works by sticking reflective balls onto a suit actor, representing the joints of the 3D model the motion data will be transferred to. Located around the room are cameras that together are able to track the precise location of each marker down to a fraction of a millimeter. The system was actually originally used as an analysis tool in biomechanics research before later finding its uses in the entertainment industry. Some early pioneers of its use in video games include Capcom's Virtua Fighter series and Konami's Metal Gear Solid series. The animations usually still need to end up getting retouched by an animator manually to look as best as possible, but a majority of the work is done by the suit actor's performance. That's why when you see footage of suit actors at work, they really know how to emphasize each movement in a way that makes sense for the game they're acting in. It's rather funny to think about how for some of these crazy movements, a real person was responsible for acting it out in real life as part of their job. So Love in Deep Space is most well known for their interactive scenes, which from what I've seen, tend to be more serious in tone, but just recently, their summer beach themed update has released, introducing an event limited 5-star memory for each of the male leads, and they're a bit on the goofier side. So now when I see the animations, all I can think about is, did they have mocap actors get launched in the air to simulate them flying off a water slide? And were the flyboard scenes done with mocap? Because I imagine that would be pretty difficult to pull off. The game also features more intimate scenes, so there is a high chance that one suit actor out there is living out the dreams of every Love in Deep Space fan. Animation is very important, of course, but they wouldn't be able to sell any immersion if they weren't used on high quality models. I have a previous video where I learned all the basics, so I'm fairly familiar with how insanely difficult it is to make a good 3D model, but it gets exponentially harder when you're dealing with a more realistic style compared to, say, an anime style. According to an interview with the game's developers conducted by IGN, they used an array of 50 different cameras to do a high quality scan for the sake of capturing high precision data for muscle simulation and reshaping. Well, we can clearly see that they put all of that data to use, considering how many times I've seen these guys without their shirts on. They also stated that the team developed an automated cloth simulator, which makes sense because really loose and flowy clothing can deform in an infinite amount of ways that would be really time consuming to do by hand, but at least for the new summer outfits that just dropped, there's not a whole lot of cloth there to be simulated. But in other cases, it does look quite natural. So yeah, there's a lot of effort put in just to construct the bodies of these models, but those are arguably much less important than each character's face. You might have heard of the concept of the uncanny valley before, which describes the situation where something appears to be human, but looks unsettling because something about it is distinctly non-human. Think the 2004 Polar Express movie, which was pretty groundbreaking in its use of motion capture technology at the time, but its characters do look a little creepy. The characters in Love in Deep Space look really good, both in the sense of resembling humans and also in being very conventionally attractive. I'm sure the same scanning technology was responsible for that, but faces are also very unique in how they move to make various expressions. Because we see human faces every day, we're pretty good at telling how they're supposed to look, which again makes it logical to use motion capture instead of attempting to recreate something so complex manually. According to the aforementioned IGN interview, Love in Deep Space uses an advanced performance capture system that can record in actors' expressions and movements at up to 300 frames per second. To put this in perspective, this is the 2011 game LA Noire, which was developed by Team Bondi and published by Rockstar Games, and used a special facial capture setup which was revolutionary for the time. You might not recognize the name, but you probably have seen this meme, which came from this game. Besides that, the game is known for its extremely detailed and realistic facial expressions, even if the other aspects of the visuals do look dated. This was achieved by a unique 32 camera setup surrounding the actor, which recorded at the 30 FPS the game was locked at. This motion scan technology was vital for LA Noire's gameplay, which has you play as a detective, making it important to be able to read a suspect's facial cues to determine if they are lying or not. Unfortunately, this was also very expensive and tedious to work with, as the precision was a double-edged sword, which made it so any desired adjustments would ultimately require a reshoot of the entire scene to properly fit in. Additionally, body capture had to be shot separately because of how large the setup for the face capture was, and the actors had to have extensive makeup work done since those details would translate to their models, adding more layers of complication. Thus, the technology, while groundbreaking in some ways, ended up not catching on for other games. It's now commonplace for actors to have a camera directly in front of their face to track markers, the black dots all over their face, allowing them to provide the mocap for everything all at the same time, like as shown with Naughty Dog's The Last of Us Part 2. I'm sure this also helps a lot with actors being able to go all out on their performances. This is likely the technology that Love in Deep Space uses, and it just goes to show how far it's progressed to the point where it's flexible to use while still being precise enough to accurately portray human expressions. But none of this would be able to come together if it weren't for the technology inside the devices we use to play games. Unlike animation done for film, you can't just pre-render everything and send over the video file afterwards, because video games are defined by their interactivity. So having the elements on screen react to decisions you make or actions you do requires animations to be rendered by your device in real time. This is the reason optimization for games is so important, as having an unstable frame rate can completely ruin the experience of playing any game. This includes things like how many polygons your models have, how busy your backgrounds are, ensuring that anything off-screen isn't taking up resources, and optimizing how lighting is calculated. And I'm sure there's many other things which I'm unfamiliar with that are just as important. This makes it all the more impressive that developers are able to deliver on immersive 3D experiences, even on smartphones that aren't specifically designed for gaming like consoles are. The technology for the 3D animation pipeline is still continuing to evolve, as games like Capcom's Monster Hunter Wilds are able to use real-time transposing of suit actors' movements onto in-game characters within their Resident Evil engine. It's seriously insane that stuff like this is even possible to do now. It's undeniable that motion capture is amazing for what it's been able to accomplish, but one of its biggest drawbacks has always been its accessibility. You need specialized cameras, markers, and an open space to film in. Renting out someone else's studio can run you between $500 to $2,000 per hour. However, the technology for smaller scale uses has also continued to grow. We now have motion capture suits with embedded technology that are able to track their own movements and convert them into data, and while they're not exactly cheap, still costing a few thousand dollars, they are at least yours to use if you buy one. Though if we're talking about games, you can get away with using a lot less. Your iPhone's face tracking used for Face ID already projects infrared dots onto your face to unlock your phone, and that can be used by third-party apps for motion capture. When it comes to body tracking, you can also get away with just using basic camera setups thanks to modern software. I typically dislike the use of AI for plenty of reasons, but I have to concede that this is one of the areas where it seems incredibly useful. All you have to do is record a video, and it does the rest of the work to convert the data into a 3D animation without any of the upfront costs while being extremely portable. Of course, the downside is that it won't be nearly as precise, but you'd probably be manually cleaning it up anyway. I hope you learned something interesting about 3D modeling and animation, because it truly is fascinating stuff. I'm not an expert or anything, but doing the research for this video was pretty eye-opening in a lot of ways. Thank you to Star Ace for sponsoring this video. If you thought the game looks interesting, you can download it on iOS or Android using the link in the description or pinned comment. The current Beast-themed event will run until the end of August, so don't miss out. That's all for the video. Thanks for watching.